Good day, first Wednesday. I guess, you know, I mean, to me, I thought address some needs on the team. Excited about the guys coming in. And as I was saying, recruiting, I guess we'll find out here in a year or so how good a day it was with those guys coming in. But we're excited about guys that are coming to play for us.
A near record haul in JUCO for December. Was that a combination of need, availability, opportunity, a little everything?
You know, I think, you know, we just go out as we rate players, and you're looking at players at need by position. Some, you know, for us, fill immediate needs that way and expect guys to get on the field to play. You know, you're looking at guys, there's some really good players in that group that, you know, we felt are really going to contribute to our team. And it just, you know, I guess it just played out that way for us.
Talk about, obviously, not just JUCO transfers, but about half of that group have been on the D1 level before. Talk about the difference in having done that before.
Yeah, a lot of guys that go to JUCO are very desperate to get back because they know what they're missing at JUCO sometimes. And as far as facilities, training, all the other stuff that they have here. So, you know, good. I mean, like, those guys, they'll know what to expect coming in day one.
You had a few weeks off and then had the young guys working early on. How long does it take to kind of get back in that game practice mode? Obviously, preparation started Wednesday.
I tell you, I thought our guys on Wednesday did a great job. Wednesday, we had a great practice Wednesday. You know, so I was really pleased with that, of how we, you know, they flipped the switch back into game week. And that was fantastic. We were a little slower day yesterday. I don't know if it was weather-based type of deal. Okay, it's been like, I mean, it's 70 to 30, back to 70 tomorrow, then 30 on Sunday, or what? I mean, it's been crazy. But we had a real good day today in it, and so we'll wrap up tomorrow with like a regular Thursday. It's like a Thursday practice for us, where, you know, we walk off the field tomorrow, we should be just about ready to go play that game. And that's how the confidence you want to have leaving practice tomorrow.
When you're looking at tape of a team that lost their first six games and won six in a row, do you look back at the September tape, or you just watch the last six games?
Oh, you watch everything a little bit, but you pay a little bit more attention to the last six games, where you know how they're playing in those games and the confidence they're playing with.
What do you see from the newer tapes maybe than the older?
Well, you know, a team that plays with a little bit more confidence. You know, I mean, it's not like they were getting crushed early in the season, you know, and then all of a sudden the light came on for them. They were battling. They had some tough losses early in the season. And then they just kind of started making the plays and having the confidence to win the games later in the year.
Peter mentioned when you get to St. Petersburg, it's kind of just refining the game plan. How much do you just kind of take what you maybe see in this week and just kind of maybe make some changes if you see any changes?
Well, that's how we've always done it, you know, for us is, you know, as we prep like it's game week and finishing game week on Thursday or tomorrow on a Thursday practice. So when you get down to the bowl site, there's a lot that goes on. You know, you're in a new city. You're exciting. You're in a different facility, different practice facility, different meeting facility. You know, I think we have a beach day, a Busch Gardens day. There's all kinds of different activities, and so you want to make sure that the guys know the game plan and are confident in the game plan before you get there. So when you're there, you're really just redoing the practices you've already done to build up that confidence. And if we have to make a tweak or change within it, we will. But hopefully we've got most of those changes done this week.
Bill told us that you had some really good performances academically by this team in the fall.
Yeah, we just got the grades. I think we had over 30-some guys with over 30 guys with over a 3.0 GPA. Mm-hmm. I'm sure they'll release whatever. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Have they released it yet or no?
We will.
Huh? You will?
Yeah, we got the 4.0 guys.
Yeah, I'm pretty pleased academically. You know, as I said, great motivation for guys, you know, because we're going to get to play in a bowl game because of our academics. So, you know, hopefully that message to the young guys, that's got to sink in of how important it is to be a champion in the classroom as well as on the field.